Good morning, students.
Good morning, ma'am.
All of you, please switch on your videos. Okay. So yesterday we discussed about the eddy currents and what about the drawbacks of eddy currents and applications of eddy currents. And we just start about the induction. So once again, we can recall the applications of eddy currents, and after that we can come to the class. So starting with Diya, can you say any two applications of eddy currents? Any two applications of eddy currents?
Breaking train and electromagnetic
Electromagnetic damping and magnetic breaking train. Okay. Naureen, any other two applications?
Induction furnace and electric power meters.
And what is the use of this induction furnace?
It is used to make alloys from metals.
Okay. It is used to make the alloys from metals. Okay. Good. Then Punya, is there any drawback for the eddy currents?
Produces large amount of heat.
Yes, it will dissipate, or it is loses the energy in the form of heat. And then Achyut, what are the methods that we can take in order to avoid this loss of heat energy? Yes. Lamination, and one more method is there?
Copper plate in different pattern.
Okay. Cut the copper plate in a specific pattern. And yesterday we just start with the induction. Vidur, can you say what you mean by induction?
It is a current production in the coil due to the change in the magnetic flux in itself or another coil.
Okay. Induction means the generation or the production of current due to the change in magnetic flux. And where the change in magnetic flux occurs in two places. It can be either within the coil itself, or it is in the nearby coil. So depending upon that, we can classify the induction into two. One is self-induction and other is mutual induction. So today we are going to discuss about it. Okay, so let us start. So induction is defined as the current production in the coil due to the change in the magnetic flux in itself or in another coil. Then we discuss about inductance. Inductance is a quantity which measures this induction. So induction is a process of production of current due to the change in the magnetic flux, and that change in magnetic flux is occurs within the coil or due to the presence of the nearby coil. And here inductance is a term associated with this induction. It is a quantity that measures the induction, and this inductance is also called coefficient of induction. Inductance is also called a coefficient of induction. And the coefficient of induction is defined as the ratio of current induced with respect to the magnetic flux. It is the ratio of current induced with respect to the magnetic flux. So we have two definitions for inductance. Inductance is a quantity that measures the induction. It is also known as coefficient of induction. So inductance can define in another way. It is the ratio of. It is the ratio of current induced with respect to the magnetic flux. Okay. Now the flux through the coil phi is directly proportional to I. We know that. What do you mean by magnetic flux? Magnetic flux means the total number of magnetic field lines that is passing through a given material. Suppose if you are consider a material, the total number of magnetic field lines that is passing through a given material is known as flux. It is represented by phi b. The magnetic flux is represented by phi b. And from the previous class itself, we discussed that whenever the amount of current that is flowing through a material is increases, the magnetic field associated with that corresponding material is increases. As a result, more and more magnetic field lines is passing through the material. So automatically the flux associated with the material is also increases. So we can say that phi b is directly proportional to I. Okay, so all these definitions are starting with the magnetic flux. What do you mean by magnetic flux? Magnetic flux is the total number of magnetic field lines that is passing through a given material. And we know that the current I is directly proportional to magnetic field. That is, it is a factor that is depends upon the magnetic field. The strength of the magnetic field can be increased or enhanced by increasing the rate of current that is flowing through it. So whenever a large number of current or large amount, not number, whenever there is a large amount of current is passing through a material, magnetic field of corresponding material is increases. So whenever the magnetic field increases, more and more magnetic field lines is passing through the given material. Correspondingly, what happens to magnetic flux? The magnetic flux is also increases, phi b increases. So from this we can say that the magnetic flux phi b is directly proportional to current that is flowing through a conductor. The magnetic flux phi b is directly proportional to current flowing through a conductor. If there is n number of turns are there for a given conductor, then the equation becomes n phi b is proportional to I. If there is n number of turns are present in the conductor, then the equation becomes n phi b is proportional to I. Or we can write n phi b is equal to a constant into I. A constant into I. Where this constant of proportionality is known as inductance. This constant of proportionality is known as inductance. So here we are starting with the magnetic flux phi b. The magnetic flux phi b is directly proportional to current. If there is n number of turns, suppose here instead of this material, if we are consider a coil, if we are consider a coil, then depending upon the number of turns, the equation becomes n phi b is directly proportional to I. Or we can replace this proportionality sign by introducing a constant. So we can write n phi b is equal to a constant into I, and this constant of proportionality is known as inductance. Is it clear? The flux through the coil is, that is phi, the flux through a coil is directly proportional to current. If there are n number of turns, the total flux is known as the flux linkage. If there is n number of turns present in the coil, then this term n phi is called flux linkage. That flux linkage is directly proportional to the current. Or we can write that flux linkage n phi is equal to a constant into I. That flux linkage n phi is equal to a constant into I. And this constant of proportionality is known as inductance. So depending upon the induction, we have a variation in this constant. If it is a self-inductance, we are representing that constant in terms of L. If it is a mutual induction, we are representing the constant as M. That is what is we are going to discuss in our next session. So here you are only trying to understand inductance means a constant of proportionality in this equation. N phi is directly proportional to I, or we can say N phi is equal to constant into I. That constant of proportionality is known as inductance. Is it clear? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And this physical quantity, inductance, is a scalar quantity. It is a scalar quantity and its unit is Henry. Okay. Is there any correction in the spelling? We'll check and inform. The unit of inductance is Henry. It is a scalar quantity because it has only magnitude. There is no direction. And that magnitude or the unit of the inductance is Henry. No. Okay, no change. HENRY. Unit is Henry. 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 So this unit is named after the scientist Joseph Henry, because he made a lot of contributions to the world of, or to the field of this electromagnetic induction. That is why, in order to honor him, we give this unit for of inductance. The unit of inductance is taken as Henry. Okay. And then this physical quantity inductance is depends upon the geometry of the coil and the nature of the material on which it is wound. Okay, the quantity inductance is depends upon the geometry. It is shape, it is depends upon the shape of the coil and also the nature of the material on which it is wound. So inductance is known as the constant of proportionality, or it is also known as the coefficient of induction. It is a scalar quantity and its SI unit is Henry. And it is depends upon the geometry of the coil and also the nature of the material of it on which it is wound. Okay, now we have, there are two types of inductions are there, based upon whether the change in magnetic flux is occurs within the coil itself or it is on the nearby coil. We have two types of induction. One is self induction and other is mutual induction. So we have mainly two types of induction, self-induction and a mutual induction. There will be a change in the magnetic flux in the coil itself. We can call it as self-induction, and it is denoted by the letter L. If the change in the magnetic flux in the coil itself, because of which a current will be induced in itself. Okay. If the change in the magnetic flux is occurs in the coil itself, it induces an EMF. That induced EMF is generate or produce an induced current in the same coil itself, then we can call it as self-induction. That is what is known as self-induction. It is denoted by the letter L. Now the second one is mutual induction. In mutual induction, we are considering two coils. Okay, because the EMF, the change in magnetic flux is occurs in one coil, and the current is induced on the another coil. That is what is takes place in the mutual induction. In mutual induction, we consider two coils. If there is a change in the magnetic flux in one coil, that produces or induces a current in the second coil. That is what is known as mutual induction. And it is denoted by the letter M, capital letter M. So we have two types of induction, self-induction and mutual induction, depending upon whether the magnetic flux, change in the magnetic flux is occurs within the same coil itself or in the nearby coil. We can classify the induction into two types. One is self-induction and other is mutual induction. If the change in the magnetic flux is occurs in one coil and it will induces a current in the same coil itself, we can call it as self-induction. It is denoted by the letter L. In the case of mutual induction, we consider the two coils. The change in magnetic flux is occurs in one coil, and as a result, the current is induced in the nearby coil or in the second coil. We can call it as mutual induction. It is represented by the letter M. Is it clear? Okay. So once again, we can recall all the topics. After that, we can move to the self-induction in detail. So, yes. Yes, Achyut. Yes.
I did not complete writing.
Okay. So types of induction. We have two different types of induction depending upon whether the magnetic flux is induced within the coil itself or it is developed by the nearby coil, we can classify the induction into two types. One is self-induction and other is mutual induction. Okay. If the magnetic flux is developed in the coil itself, and due to the change in this magnetic flux, if the current is induced in the same coil itself, we can call it as self-induction. It is denoted by the letter L. The second type of induction is mutual induction. So in the case of mutual induction, as its name implies, it is a mutual relationship. So here we consider the two types of coil. The change in magnetic flux is occurs in the one coil. As a result, the current is induced in the nearby coil. So we can call it as mutual induction, and it is denoted by the letter M, capital letter M. Okay, so once again, we can recall all these points. After that, we can discuss about the self-induction in detail. So starting, I request all of you, please switch on your videos. Those who are not facing any network issues, please switch on your videos. Okay, then Adul, what do you mean by inductance?
It's a measure of induction.
It is a measure of induction. And then what is the equation for measuring this inductance, Aditya?
And 5B directly proportional to I.
5B is directly proportional to I. If there is n number of coils, what will be the equation becomes?
N into 5B equal to conductance into I.
Not conductance, a constant into I. That constant of proportionality is known as inductance. Okay. All right. Then Evelyn, what are the two classification of induction?
Self-induction and mutual induction.
Self-induction and mutual induction. Very good. Then Aryan, what do you mean by self-induction? Self-induction. Aryan, are you there? The same question to Anna, self-induction.
Ma'am, the current will be induced by itself.
How this current is induced in that coil?
By the change in the magnetic flux.
Very good. If the change in magnetic flux is occurs in the coil, and if the current is induced in the same coil itself, we can call it a self-induction. And which letter is used to represent the self-induction, Achyut?
Yeah.
Capital letter L. Then Mehak, what do you mean by mutual induction? Mehak, mutual induction. The same question to Emmanuel. What do you mean by mutual induction?
Change in the magnetic flux of one coil, then the magnetic field in the second coil is changed. Second coil magnetic flux is.
And how we can represent this mutual induction?
By M.
By capital letter M. All right, Michael, on which are the factors or the term inductance is depends? What are the factors on which the physical quantity inductance depends? Michael? Same question to Nandana.
Geometry of the coil and nature of the material on which the coil is wound.
Okay, it is depends upon the geometry of the coil, and also it is depends upon the nature of the material of the conductor. I hope these topics are clear, right? Is it clear? Can we move to the next topic? All right. So now we are going to discuss about the self-induction in detail. So all of you write the next heading, self-induction. Self-induction. So we can see, let us see how the self-induction is takes place. Okay. So in order to explain the self-induction, here we consider a coil. Consider a coil. And the ends of the coil is attached to a cell. and a tap key. Here we consider a coil and the ends of the coil attaches to a cell and a tap key, or simply the key, the switch. Okay. Now, students, can you say what about the position of the key or the switch now? Is it closed or in open state?
Open.
It is in open state. So my question, does the current flow occurs through the coil in during this state?
No.
No, because here the key is open or the switch is open. So there is no current flow is occurs through this circuit. So initially, the current I is equal to zero. The current that is flowing through the circuit is equal to zero because here the key is open state. Okay, the tap key is in the open state. So there will be no current flowing through the circuit. So the current through the circuit I is equal to zero. Now, I press the key. Now, what about the flow of current? Yes, now the current is started to flow through the circuit. It is started from the positive terminal and it is passing through the coil and reaches to the negative terminal of the cell. The current flow is occurs through the circuit. So here the current is started to increase. It is started to increase from a zero to a maximum value, right? So in the first case, the tap key is on stage. That is, the circuit is not closed. There will be no current flow is occurs. In the second stage, I press the key. Whenever I press the key, the current is started to flow through the circuit because now the circuit is closed. So the current flow is occurs through the circuit. Okay. So we can say that the current is increases from a zero to a maximum value. Current is increases from a zero to a maximum value. Then what happens to the magnetic field associated with the coil? Here the current is initially zero. Now it is changes from zero to a maximum value. Then what happens to magnetic field B associated with this coil? What happens to magnetic field B associated with this coil? Unmute and say it's right. Yes, it is also increases from zero to a maximum value because we already studied in our previous class, the current is directly proportional to that of the magnetic field. Whenever the amount of current that is passing through a conductor is increasing, what happens to magnetic field? Magnetic field is also automatically increasing because the rate of current I is directly proportional to magnetic field. So in the second stage, whenever I press the key, the current is started to flow through the coil. So the current is increases from zero to a maximum value. Then the magnetic field B is also increases from zero to a maximum value. So we can say that the magnetic field lines are passing through this coil because here the magnetic field is increases from a zero to a maximum value. So the magnetic field lines are passing through the coil. So my next question, then what happens to the magnetic flux associated with the coil? What is magnetic flux? Try to recall what you mean by magnetic flux. What is magnetic flux, Vidur?
The number of field lines passing through a given area.
Yes, it is the total number of field lines that is passing through a given material or a given conductor. So here the magnetic field is increases from zero to maximum. So what happens? Magnetic field lines are started to flow through this conductor. Then can you say what happens to the value of magnetic flux?
It increases
from zero to a maximum value, right? This also increases from a zero to a maximum value. So in the second stage, whenever the key is pressed, the current is started to flow through the conductor. That is, the value of the current is increases from zero to a maximum value. When the current increases, automatically the magnetic field associated with this conductor is increases from zero to a maximum value because both these quantities are directly proportional to each other. Whenever the value of the magnetic field is increases from zero to maximum, magnetic field lines are passing through the conductor. So we know that magnetic field lines is something that is associated with the magnetic flux. That is, the total number of field lines passing through a given conductor is known as magnetic flux. So here we can write that the magnetic flux is increases from zero to a maximum value, right? So what happens to the magnetic flux here? Is it is remains constant or it is changes? What happens to magnetic flux? Is it remains constant? It remains in the zero state itself? It is changes from zero to a maximum value. So we can say that magnetic flux change occurs, right? Here the magnetic flux change occurs. Whenever the magnetic flux is change associated with it, whenever the magnetic flux associated with a conductor is changes, what generated in this conductor?
Induced EMF.
Very good. Induced EMF is generated. And this induced EMF in turn produces what? It in turn produces?
Induced current.
Induced current. Okay. So here, whenever the key is pressed, what happens? The current is started to flow through the conductor. So the rate of the current is increases from zero to a maximum value. As a result, the magnetic field associated with this conductor is also increases from zero to a maximum value. So the magnetic flux associated with the conductor is also changes from zero to maximum value. That is what is the basic principle of this chapter. Whenever there is a change in magnetic flux occurs, it induces an EMF in the conductor. As a result, it induces an EMF in the conductor, and that induced EMF is induced a current in the same coil. Okay. So here the change in magnetic flux is occurs in the this coil itself, and that change in magnetic flux induces an current or it is induces an EMF initially. That induced EMF is generated an induced current. That induced current is also flow through the same coil itself. That is why we call it as self-induction. Is it clear? You just try to recall what you mean by self-induction. Self-induction means if a change in the magnetic flux is occurs in a coil, and due to that change in the magnetic flux, if the induced current is generated in the same coil itself, we can call it as self-induction. Okay. Now we have to discuss one more condition. For suppose students, you just imagine if I press the key for a long time, that is if the circuit is continuously on stage, if the circuit is undergoes a continuously on stage, then what about the value of the current then in the circuit, value of the current? If we are pressing the key for a long time, we are not releasing it from the on position, it is pressing for a long time, what about the value of current?
Constant.
It remains constant, right? It is because it is reaches from zero to a maximum value. It reaches its peak value. Then it is remains constant. Then does there any change in the magnetic field occurs here? No. The magnetic field is also remains constant. That is, if we are pressing the key for a long time, the current remains constant. Again, the magnetic field remains constant. If the magnetic field is remains constant, we can say that the magnetic flux phi b is also remains constant. That is, there is no rate of change of magnetic flux occurs. If there is no rate of change of magnetic flux is occurs, we can say that there is no induced EMF generated here, which in turn does not produce any kind of induced current. It does not produce any kind of induced current. Now, in the third case, if I again releases the key, if I release the key, okay, now I release the key. That is, the current is not flow through the circuit. Then what happens to the value of current now? Now I release the key. What about the value of current? Is it is remains in the maximum value? Yes, it is not remains in the maximum value. When I am releasing the key, what happens? The current flow is not occurs. So it is returns from a maximum to a minimum value. Again, it is seems to be zero. So in the third case, whenever I release the key, what happens? The current is changes from a maximum to a minimum value. We are considered just to the reverse case. then what happens to the magnetic field associated with it? Magnetic field B. Here the current is decreases from a maximum to a minimum value. Then what happens to the magnetic field B? Yes, it is also reduces from a maximum to a minimum value. It also decreases from a maximum to a minimum value. Then what happens to magnetic flux associated with it? Whenever the magnetic field is reduces from a maximum to a minimum value, the number of magnetic field lines are seems to be decreases from here. Okay, a less number of magnetic field lines is passing through the coil. It is passing through the coil. Then what happens to the magnetic flux? Phi B.
Decreases.
It is also decreases from a maximum to a minimum value, right? It also decreases from a maximum to minimum value. Here also we can say a change in the magnetic flux occurs. Here also a change in the magnetic flux occurs. So the change in the magnetic flux induces an EMF in the coil. That induced EMF is generate an induced current in the coil. Okay, so that is what is known as self-induction, or we can call it as that is what is known as self-induction. Or so here from this activity or from this observation we can say that here the current is produced, here an induced current is produced in the coil due to the change in magnetic flux within the same coil itself. That is what is known as self-induction. Okay, we are already discussed the definition of self-induction. Now we see how the self-induction is takes place in a coil. With the same coil itself, how the self-induction phenomenon is takes place. So here we consider the three cases. Initially the key is in the open state. No current is flow through the circuit. So during that stage, the current flow through the circuit I is equal to zero. Whenever the key is pressed, whenever the key is pressed, what happens? The current is started to increases from zero to a maximum value. As a result, the magnetic field associated with the same coil is changes, because the magnetic field is a quantity that is directly proportional to the current. So whenever the current is increases, the magnetic field is also started to increases from zero to a maximum value. So maximum number of field lines are passing through our coil. So we can say that the flux associated with the coil is also changes from zero to a maximum value. Now, in the third case, again we release the key. So whenever we release the key, the current is started to reduce from a maximum to a zero value. So whenever the current is decreasing, the magnetic field is also started to decreases from a maximum to zero value. So minimum number of field lines are passing through the coil. So the value of the magnetic flux is also decreases from maximum to zero value. So here also a magnetic flux change, a flux change is occurs. So whenever the flux is changed, we can say that it will induces an EMF. Whether it is increases from zero to maximum or it is decreases from maximum to zero, there is a change in the flux is occurs. If there is a change in the flux occurs, what happens? It will induce an EMF in the coil, and that induced EMF will generate an induced current. Okay, so the flux change is occurs in this coil. That change in the flux is induces an EMF in the same coil. That is why we call it as self-induction. That is why we call it as self-induction. So from this observation, we can write the magnetic flux phi B is directly proportional to the induced current. The magnetic flux phi B is directly proportional to the induced current. Okay. So from this current, we can say that the magnetic flux phi B is directly proportional to induced current. That is, if the current increases, the magnetic flux is also increases. If the current decreases, magnetic flux associated with the coil is also decreases. And in physics, we have a tendency to replace this proportionality sign. So here we are replace this proportionality sign. Phi B is equal to, can you guess the constant here? What is the constant? Here we are discussing about the self-induction. Self induction is denoted by
L.
So 5B is equal to L into I. Okay. So here this L is the constant of proportionality. This constant of proportionality is known as self inductance. Here this L is known as the constant of proportionality because the magnetic flux phi B is directly proportional to I. In order to replace this proportionality sign, here we introduce a constant. Since it is self-induction, it is denoted by capital letter L. So we can write phi B is equal to LI. Phi B is equal to LI, where this L is known as self-inductance. Okay. We know that inductance is a measure of induction. So here self-inductance is a measure of self-induction. Inductance means coefficient of induction. That is what is mean by inductance. Or the constant of proportionality is known as inductance. So here L is known as, it is a constant of proportionality. It is known as self-inductance. Yes.
I and B is constant. Can you tell what happens to current?
Which one?
Ma'am, when I is constant and B is constant, then I is also constant. After that.
Okay, in the fourth case. Okay. Whenever the current, that if we are pressing the key for a long time, that case you want to explain again?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so if the key is pressing for a long time, the current remains constant. The current is reaches a maximum value, it is neither changed to a zero or further increase. It remains a constant value. So whenever the current I is remains constant, the magnetic field associated with the coil is also remains constant. Okay, it is neither increase nor decrease. The magnetic field is also remains constant. So what happens? Magnetic field lines that is passing through the coil is also remains constant. There is no change in the number of magnetic field lines that is passing through the coil. As a result, we can say that the magnetic flux is also remains constant. Magnetic fluxes change if and only if the number of magnetic field lines are increasing or decreasing. But here, the number of magnetic field lines that is passing through a coil is remains constant. So we can say that the magnetic flux associated with the coil is also remains constant. There is no change in the number of magnetic field lines that is passing through the material. It remains constant. So the magnetic flux associated with it is also a constant value. Is it clear now?
Yes, ma'am. So no EMF, right?
Ah, yes. If the magnetic flux is not changes, it will not induce any EMF. There is no EMF, no current is induced in the coil during that time. Okay, but whenever we suddenly release the key, this current is suddenly start to flow from a maximum value to a minimum value, that is to a zero value. So whenever the current is decreases from a maximum to minimum value, the magnetic field is also decreases from maximum to minimum value, then the magnetic flux phi B is also decreases from maximum to minimum value because minimum number of field lines is passing through the coil during that time. So the magnetic flux phi B is also decreases from maximum to minimum value, or it is decreases from maximum to zero value. So here also we can say a change in the magnetic fluxes takes place. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So from this observation, we can say that phi B is directly proportional to I. If the current is changes, that change is occurs to our magnetic flux phi B. So in order to replace that proportionality sign, here we are introduce a constant phi B is equal to L into I, where L is known as self-inductance. L is known as the self-inductance.
Ma'am.
Yes.
In the definition, we wrote self-induction as L.
Oh, yes. Actually, the self-inductance. Self-inductance is represented by the letter L, not self-induction. Similarly, you can correct it in the mutual induction also. Mutual inductance is represented by the letter M. It is a constant of proportionality.
So ma'am, self induction does not have any symbol.
No, no symbol for self. It is a phenomenon. It's a phenomenon. There is no symbol for self induction. Actually, the self inductance is something that is related to that of self induction. That is why we are used to represent it with the L itself. So you can write self inductance is represented by the letter L.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Now, okay, it's the time. 1 more minute. Students, you just imagine if the current that is flowing through the coil is 1 ampere. So let us suppose if current I is passing through the coil is 1 ampere, then what is the equation becomes? If the current that is passing through the coil I is equal to 1 ampere, then what is the equation becomes?
Phi B is equal to L.
Yes, exactly. Phi B is equal to L. So here we get a definition for self-inductance. We can say that the self-inductance of a coil is equal to the magnetic flux associated with the coil when the current flows through the coil is equal to 1 ampere. Okay, so when the current flowing through the coil is equal to 1 ampere, we can write phi B is equal to L. So you can write the self-inductance of a coil, that is L. The self-inductance of a coil is equal to the magnetic flux of the coil. The self-inductance of a coil is equal to the magnetic flux of the coil when the current flowing through the coil is equal to 1 ampere. When the current flowing through the coil is equal to 1 ampere.